Hi children, this is the second session. In this session we are going, previously we have discussed about aquatic plants. Now the second session is about the terrestrial plants. So the terrestrial plants means what? The plants which live on the land. So these are defined into five types, differentiated into five types. The first one is plains, next one is hilly regions, next one is windy regions, next one is deserts and marshy regions. Plains. Plains means what? The plants which live on the plain surface. Plain surface means what? What? See the grounds. When they are plain in shape. For example, take a banyan tree. Take a big banyan tree. Where do they grow? In the plain surface only, no? Not in the hilly regions. These grow in very hot regions and very less rainfall. Also, these trees can grow very nicely. So, see here, let us discuss about this. See, in places with hot weather and small rainfall, plants shed their leaves during autumn season. So, when the leaves are shutting down in the autumn season, these plants are called as deciduous plants. Deciduous plants means what? The plants which shed their leaves in the autumn season are called as deciduous plants. What are the examples? Peepal tree and banyan tree. Peepal tree and banyan tree. See, next one is the plants which grow in hot weather and heavy rainfall. Plants having green leaves throughout the year are called as evergreen trees. What are the examples? Coconut tree and eucalyptus tree. So we are very familiar with the coconut tree. So can we see the coconut tree dried up anytime? No, because this tree is evergreen for whole year. So these are called as evergreen trees. All these trees grow in which areas? Plain areas. So let us go to let us move to the next topic, plants in hilly regions. Hilly regions is what? Mountain regions. So which type of plants grow in mountain regions? Plants like fir, pine, all these grow in hilly regions. So see, these are the plants which grow in hilly regions. So how the trees are looking like? In the cone shape, means very narrow at the end. So these type of trees are growing in the hilly regions. These trees have the cones instead of flowers. So here in the cones only we find the seeds also. So let us discuss about the adaptations. The leaves of trees in hilly regions are thick, waxy and needle shaped. These help trees to survive in cold and snow. So see here, the leaves are very cone shaped so that they can survive in the cold regions. The next one is the trees have sloping branches and look conical in shape. This helps to snow to slide off easily from trees. So when the snow fall on the trees, what will happen due to that cone shape? What will happen? Immediately the snow will fall down from the upper surface to lower surface. In for that reason only these trees are in conical in shape. Next, the coniferous trees produce cones instead of flowers. See here, these are in cone shapes instead of flowers, and these cones consist of seeds. This is about the plants in hilly regions. What are the examples for this? Pine and fir. The next topic is plants in windy regions. Windy regions is what? All the grasslands comes under windy region plants. So what are the adaptations here? See, in this tree, how the tree is looking like? The tree is completely flat topped. The tree is completely flat topped so that when the wind blow also the tree can be survived. See here, trees in windy regions are flat topped or umbrella shaped. They are therefore not easily bent or broken by strong winds. Due to this flat topped, what will happen? When the wind blows also the tree will be survived. This is about the windy region. The next one is plants in deserts. What are deserts? The areas which have very less rainfall. So the plants which survive in these areas need very less water, such as cactus plant. So see here. So I'll show the picture. See here. This is the aloe vera plant and this is the cactus plant. These two can be survived in the desert areas, means very the areas which has very less water. See here, cactus and aloe vera both have maximum thorns only. So thorns will consume less water. because these areas have very less water. No, due to that they have thorns and very consume very less water. Let us see the adaptations for this desert plants. See the first one, the root system of the xerophytes is very well developed. So the plants which live in the deserts are called as xerophytes. These plants have very well equipped root system. They can be moved into deep into the soil for in search of water. See, it can reach great depths in search of water. The next one is, more desert plants have thorns. These have thorns to reduce loss of water. Next one is, plants such as cactus have thick and fleshy stems that store water. See, the cactus has very fleshy thick skin to reduce the loss of water. Next, leaves of the aloe vera plant have a waxy coating which acts like plastic and does not allow water to escape. Due to this thick skin, what will happen? The water will not escape outside the plant. These are the adaptations of desert plants. The next one is marshy regions. What is marshy? Marshy means what? Very wet regions. Means the regions which contains more water. See here. See, this is the water. And this is, so here this is the land area, this is water body. So due to this water body, what is happening? The entire land is completely wet and very soft. In this regions, these plants are growing. So see here, if you observe clearly, the roots are developed outside the soil. So due to this, the roots will take the gases directly from the air. So these roots are called as breathing roots. The plants which grow in marshy regions have the roots outside the water body soil, so that these roots will take exchange the gases directly from the air. So these roots are called as breathing roots. For example, all the mangrove forest trees are like this marshy regions only. So see here, the roots of the plants grow above the soil and absorb gases directly from the air. Hence, they are called as breathing roots. Example, mangrove forest. This is all about this lesson.